This problem is about finding the increase of pressure due to heating of a liquid in a rigid container. Let us read the problem statement. A rigid container is completely filled with a liquid having a constant isothermal compressibility of 1.09 × 10⁻⁴ bar to the power minus 1 and a constant coefficient of volume expansion of 1.12 × 10⁻³ Kelvin to the power minus 1. The liquid is initially at 300 Kelvin and 1 bar. Heat is supplied to the liquid to raise its temperature to 350 Kelvin. Assuming that no phase change occurs, the final pressure in bar of the liquid up to one decimal place is dash. This problem was asked in Gate Engineering Sciences in the year 2018. Let us write the available information. We are given with beta, kappa, initial pressure temperature and final temperature. So it is given as the beta, which is coefficient of volume expansion, is given as 1.12 × 10⁻³ Kelvin to the power minus 1, and the other data, which is kappa, which is isothermal compressibility, is equal to 1.09 × 10⁻⁴ bar to the power minus 1. So the liquid is, again it is liquid, the liquid is initially at 300 Kelvin, which means T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, and initial pressure is 1 bar. Temperature at the second final condition T2 equal to 350 Kelvin. We are asked to find what is the final pressure, P2 equal to how much. So how to find the pressure rise due to heating of a liquid? We know for a single component system, the volume, pressure and temperature are related by this way. That is, volume is a function of temperature and pressure. Simply, let us differentiate this, which is dV equal to dou V by dou T at P multiplied by dT plus dou V by dou P at T multiplied by dP. Let us again divide this entire equation by V so as to substitute in terms of beta and kappa. So dV by V equal to 1 by V dou V by dou T at P dT plus 1 by V into dou V by dou P at T into dP. We know this group 1 by V into dou V by dou T at P is called as beta, and this 1 by V dou V by dou P at T is actually minus kappa. That is, this is coefficient of volume expansion and isothermal compressibility is minus of this. So let us write them in terms of beta and kappa. So this is equal to beta dT minus kappa dP. For a rigid vessel, there is no change in volume. So this dV will be 0 because of that the left hand side is 0. So we can write this equation as kappa dP equal to beta dT. The reason is dV equal to 0 for rigid vessel, and this vessel is completely filled with liquid and there is no change of phase. That's why this dV equal to 0. So from which we can write this as dP equal to beta dT by kappa. And it is also given that beta and kappa are constant for the given ranges of pressure and temperature involved. So from which, because this beta and kappa are remaining constant, you can integrate this above equation, or else you can integrate this, which is simply delta P equal to beta by kappa into delta T. So otherwise, which is P2 minus P1 equal to beta by kappa into T2 minus T1. So what are all known to us? We need to find P2 and P1 is 1 bar, and what are all beta and kappa. Beta is given. Beta is given as 1.12 into 10 power minus 3, and kappa is 1.09 into 10 power minus 4. So we can substitute them. 1.12 into 10 power minus 3 by kappa is 1.09 into 10 power minus 4. So what is T2? T2 is given as 350 Kelvin, and T1 is 300 Kelvin. So you can confirm this data from here. So this data are already given to us. We are finding P2. So from which we'll be getting this P2 as 4.8 bar. So this pressure is huge. You know, this P2 is very high, very very high. 51 after about 500 bars. No, this 500 bar for a change of 550 degrees Celsius. Only increase of 50 degrees Celsius is creating a pressure rise of about 500 bar. To be precise, it is 513.8 bar is the pressure rise, and P2 is 514.8 bar. So in filling this rigid container with liquid, always we should ensure that there is some empty space left with, so that the liquid can vaporize and we won't encounter the situation of completely filled container, thereby increasing the enormous pressure rise. Hope you had some learning. Thank you.